Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my YouTube channel. And since last 2-3 weeks I was not posting any latest video, but now I come up with the latest playlist on the GraphQL, playlist on all different kind of ORMs in the Node.js, and we'll also talk about Kubernetes, the Neo4j and everything from the latest technical stack. Okay, so this playlist will primarily talk about the GraphQL things. So if you talk about the GraphQL ecosystem that is totally exploding these days, we have a lot of new libraries are coming and a lot of new frameworks are coming that is supporting the GraphQL client, GraphQL server, all these things. So if you talk about simple GraphQL, you can create a simple GraphQL server on top of Express, you can use Apollo, you can use Yoga, you can use different kind of libraries to build a simple GraphQL server. So we are going to talk about all those things. So this playlist is primarily going to talk about all these different libraries. We have GQL, Type GraphQL, we have GraphQL iOS, FastQL, Nano GraphQL, Prisma, which is kind of the latest technology, and it is known as a lightweight ORM for the Node.js connecting to all different database. And there is a Yoga, which is a GraphQL, which is a library helping us to create a GraphQL server. URQL, Neo4j GraphQL, which is supporting the integration with the Neo4j and expose the data in the GraphQL queries and the mutation. Apollo is already a popular stack. We are using Apollo client, Apollo server. We are using Apollo server to create a GraphQL server, right? So GraphQL libraries are like, a lot of libraries are there. If we talk about this GraphQL, GraphQL Hub, they have their own set of libraries they are using. Apollo stack has its own thing, Apollo client, Apollo server. Prisma is coming with a simple ORM, but it has a nice integration with the GraphQL servers. Okay, you are writing GraphQL server, talk to the Prisma. Prisma will take care of getting the data from this all different database. And also Prisma is providing a nice and clean database client that is totally different in the Node.js world. So we are going to use all these different libraries like Type GraphQL, GraphQL library with a simple TypeScript. We have these Neo4j GraphQL talking to the Neo4j for the GraphQL queries. Yoga is a library which is helping us to build a GraphQL server. And there are some AppSync, Apollo client for the AWS and all these things. So this library, this playlist is primarily going to talk about the GraphQL, GraphQL libraries, GraphQL ecosystem, GraphQL client, GraphQL server, what all different libraries you can use to build your GraphQL application. Like we are going to use a Yoga and Apollo stack, and then we are going to take a look onto this GraphQL, GraphQL Hub, and whole lot of this GraphQL ecosystem. So it's going to be massive because we are going to talk to different ORMs with the help of Prisma. I mean, Prisma will talk to the different database, and we can also use different Node.js ORMs. Like we are writing a GraphQL server in the graph in the Apollo, and then I need to get the data from the database using SQLize, using Type ORM, using Next or using ORM2. These different ORM libraries will help us to get the data from database, and GraphQL queries and mutation will help us to expose the data through the GraphQL client. We'll talk about GraphQL authorization, GraphQL pagination in the GraphQL, how to do the aggregation of data using writing the different schema definitions, queries and mutations and subscriptions. So it's going to be very big, and it's totally new. I mean, I don't have a playlist talking all these things together, so it's going to be massive for my subscribers. Okay, stay tuned guys. Thanks everyone.